Good morning, students. Welcome back to biology class, chapter 2, biological classification, part 4. Last class, we are discussing about the 5 kingdom classification proposed by R.H. Vittago. Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Mycota. Now, the last two classes, Kingdom Plantae and Kingdom Animalia. Today we are going to discuss a little part of the Kingdom Plantae. Okay. Kingdom Plantae includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organisms commonly called plants. Okay, they are the autotrophic and it contains the chlorophyll. Chlorophyll containing organisms commonly called plants. A few members are particularly heterotrophic. Okay, in the plant, some of them are, a few are the heterotrophic. They are depending on other organisms for food. So, we'll discuss that one. That is the insectivorous plants. Okay, where the nitrogen deficiency is there, they will absorb the insects. That the leaf containing some enzymes that will absorb the small insects, and they are from the insects they are taking absorbing the nitrogen. So they are the insectivorous plants. Example, bladderwort, Venus flytrap, and you have already studied that all the plants. Then the parasites are is there, and that the cascuta one plant, that it is a parasite. Cascuta is a parasitic plant. They are losing the chlorophyll. They are completely depending on other organisms, other plants. The plant cells have an eukaryotic structure with prominent chloroplast and cell wall mainly made up of cellulose. And later we'll study these all the structures. Now, Plantae includes algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Later we'll study this all the classification. Life cycle of plants has two distinct phases, the diploid sporophytic and the haploid gametophytic. Sporophytic is the spore producing the plants. Haploid, that is the gametophytic structure, gametes are present that alternate with each other. The length of the haploid and diploid phases and whether these phases are free living or depend on others, varying among different groups in plants. This phenomenon is called alternation of generation. This is all about the Kingdom Plantae. Next chapter we'll study detail. Now, again we'll discuss about the Kingdom Animalia. The Kingdom Animalia is characterized by the heterotrophic eukaryotic organisms that are multicellular and their cells lack cell walls. Cell wall is absent, cell membrane is present. They directly or indirectly depend on plants for food. They digest their food in an internal cavity and store food reserves as glycogen or fat. Their mode of nutrition is holozoic, by ingestion of food. They follow a definite growth pattern and grow into adults that have a definite shape and size. Higher forms show elaborate sensory and neuromotor mechanism. Most of them are capable of locomotion. Movement is present in the animals. The sexual reproduction is by copulation of male and female, followed by the embryological development. This also we'll study. Already you started studying the various phylum are describing in the next chapters. Okay, now we are going to 5 kingdom classification. Almost little portion we discussed. Now, the three organisms are not included in the R.H. Vittago's 5 kingdom classifications. We'll see what are they. In the 5 kingdom classification of Vittago, there is no mention of some of acellular organisms like viruses, viroids and lichens. These are briefly introduced here. First, we'll take the virus. All of us who have suffered of ill effects of common cold or flu know what effect viruses can have on us, even if we do not associate it with our condition. You know that now also we are suffering from the corona, that is also, it's a type of virus is affected. We cannot see that one, but it is that affecting a lot in all over the world it is. Viruses did not find a place in classification since they are not truly living. If we understand living as those organisms that have a cell structure, okay, they can show the living character when they are entering into the living organisms, showing a living character. Whenever getting, they are getting a suitable atmosphere, the temperature and the survival, then they are surviving. Okay, when they are getting the things, if it are in the non-living organisms, they can survive according to that. When they are living, they are showing the living characters. So the viruses are showing the living and non-living characters. Because of that, the viruses are not included in any of the five kingdom classification. Then the viruses are non-cellular. Cells are absent organisms that are characterized by having an inert crystalline structure outside the living cell. Once they infect a cell, they take over the machinery of the host cell to replicate themselves, killing the host, and they are living. Viruses are not living also, showing the living characters and also the non-living characters. The name virus, that means venom or poisonous fluid, was given by Pasteur D.J. Ivanovsky in 1892, recognized certain microbes as casual organisms of the mosaic disease of tobacco. These were found to be smaller than bacteria because they passed through bacteria-proof filters. M.W. Bejarnik in 1898 demonstrated that the extract of the infected plants of tobacco could cause infection in healthy plants and called the fluid as contagium vivum fluid, infectious living fluid. W.M. Stanley in 1935 showed that viruses could be crystallized, and crystals consist largely of proteins. They are inert outside their specific host cell. Viruses are obligate parasites. They can live in the parasites inside also, outside also. In addition to proteins, viruses also contain genetic material that could be protein plus either DNA or RNA, DNA virus or RNA virus. No virus contain both RNA and DNA. A virus is a nucleoprotein and the genetic material is infectious. In general, viruses that infect plants have a single-stranded RNA, and viruses that infect animals have either single or double-stranded RNA or double-stranded DNA. Bacterial viruses or bacteriophages, viruses that affect the bacteria is called bacteriophage, are usually double-stranded DNA viruses. The protein coat called capsid, made up of small subunit called capsomeres, protects the nucleic acid, or the nucleic acid means DNA or RNA. These capsomeres are arranged in helical or polyhedral geometric forms. Viruses cause diseases like mumps, smallpox, herpes, and influenza. AIDS in humans is also caused by a virus. In plants, the symptoms can be mosaic formation, leaf rolling, uncurling, yellowing, and vein clearing, dwarfing, and stunted growth. These are the viruses affecting diseases in the plants. Then we'll discuss about the viroids, same like viruses. Another one infectious organism is called viroids. In 1971, Tio Dino discovered a new infectious agent that was smaller than viruses and caused potato spindle tuber disease. It is causing only one disease, that is the potato spindle tuber disease. It was found to be a free RNA. See that one, only one genetic material is present, no protein, no DNA, only that RNA is present. It lacked the protein coat that is found in viruses, hence the name viroid. The RNA of the viroid was of low molecular weight. See that one, the comparative study. DNA and RNA is present. DNA or RNA is present in the viruses. Only RNA is present in the viroids. Protein is present in the virus, but the protein is absent in the viroids. Molecular weight is also it is low. Again, we'll discuss another one more classification. It is not included in the group of five kingdom classification. That is the lichens. See that one, viruses. They are showing the living and non-living characters, so they are not included. Viroids, they are the acellular and only the one RNA is present, so they are not showing any type of the living characters or non-living characters, so they are in the viroids. Next, one more thing is there, that is called one more organism, that is called the lichens. Lichens are symbiotic association. Symbiotic means both are benefited, mutually benefited. The two organisms are combined and both are benefited. Here it is, the lichens contains the algae and fungi. The algae, the study of algae is called phycology and the study of fungi is called mycology. Now listen here. Here the lichens means the symbiotic association between algae and fungi. The algal component is known as the phycobiont, which are autotrophic, and the fungal component is called mycobiont, which is heterotrophic. Algae prepare food for fungi, and fungi provide shelter and absorb mineral nutrients and water for its partner. So close in their association that of one lichen in nature, one would never imagine that they had two different organisms within them. Lichens are very good pollution indicators. They do not grow in polluted areas. Now we are completed this biological classification chapter, five kingdom classification, that is R.H. Whittaker. In that, not included three organisms, they are the virus, viroids and lichens. Thank you.